And a dishonest man you can always trust to be dishonest. Honestly, it's the honest ones you want to watch out for. Because you can never predict when they're going to do something incredibly stupid.
The Pirates of the Caribbean movies are populated with an ensemble of entertaining characters. But aside from just being fun to watch, each of the characters play an important role in how the first movie presents its take on the theme. I'm Evan Wessman, and this is an interior analysis of Curse of the Black Pearl. In any story that is trying to create a strong theme, the writer must first articulate the thematic question. In his talk on how to write a movie, Craig Mazin says, "The important thing is that the argument has to be an argument. I think sometimes people misunderstand the use of theme in this context, and they think a theme for a screenplay could be brotherhood. Well, no, because there's nothing to argue about there. There's no way to answer that question one way or the other, it's just a vague concept." In Curse of the Black Pearl, the thematic question is it always right to follow the rules? This is a question that could have a lot of different answers beyond just a simple yes or no, making it a good thematic question to dig into. Once the thematic question has been defined, the next thing to do is give each character a different answer to the thematic question. Whether I'm writing a story with a single protagonist or an ensemble of main characters like the Pirates movies, this is a technique that I use when crafting characters. In Curse of the Black Pearl, most of the characters show their takes on the theme within moments of being introduced. In Jack Sparrow's very first scene, we see that he has no regard for the law, and even respects those who break it.
Good man. Pirate.
And we later hear him confirm these beliefs aloud.
The only rules that really matter are these. What a man can do, and what a man can't do.
We are also shown that he is willing to help others, but will also go as far as killing someone if it benefits him.
This shot is not meant for you.
Will believes that those who follow the law are good, and rejects the fact that his father was a pirate.
He was a merchant sailor. A good, respectable man who obeyed the law.
He was a bloody pirate, a scallywag.
He even views his duel with Jack as a noble act.
I practice 3 hours a day so that when I meet a pirate, I can kill it!
Commodore Norrington takes a similar but more extreme view.
I intend to see to it that any man who sails under a pirate flag or wears a pirate brand gets what he deserves. A short drop and a sudden stop.
Which is also shared by Governor Swan.
Pirate? Hang him!
But Elizabeth disagrees and shows that she doesn't care about the law or a person's identity, only what someone does.
Pirate or not, this man saved my life.
Barboza, like Jack, obviously has no regard for the law, but is subject to a different set of rules, the Pirate Code. However, it soon becomes clear that the only rules he plays by are his own.
The code is more what you'd call guidelines than actual rules.
And that he, unlike Jack, sees no value in helping anyone else. This is contrasted by Gibbs, who respects the Pirate Code, even when following it goes against his conscience.
Keep to the code!
So in looking at all of our major characters, there is a good variety of beliefs, and a diversity of pirates, people of the law, and people who kind of straddle the two. These beliefs come into conflict with each other throughout the entire movie, and are a big part of what motivates what the characters do, and the ways that they do it.
No heroes amongst thieves, eh?
You know, for having such a bleak outlook on pirates, you're well on your way to becoming one.
You swore she'd go free!
Don't dare impugn me on her, boy! I agreed she'd go free, but it was you who failed to specify when or where.
One good deed is not enough to redeem a man of a lifetime of wickedness.
Though it seems enough to condemn him.
You cheated.
Pirate.
Hang the code and hang the rules! They're more like guidelines anyway.
You ignored the rules of engagement in a fair fight and kill you.
That's not much incentive for me to fight fair then, is it?
Even less prominent characters are able to comment on the theme.
Down to the depths, whatever mutton they thought of parley!
That would be the fringe.
But while this allows us to see the characters' beliefs in action, and even see some of them challenged, it doesn't provide an answer to the thematic question. Even after the Pearl Pirates are defeated and the curse is lifted, the story has not presented its final answer yet. It is only in the final scene of resolution when some characters actively change their answers to the thematic question that the story is able to give its overall answer. After witnessing Jack help them defeat the Pearl Pirates, Will cannot stand to let him hang. So he risks his life, his freedom, and his reputation to do what he believes is right.
He's a pirate, and a good man. If all I have achieved here is that the hangman will earn two pairs of boots instead of one, so be it.
And after Elizabeth stands in support of him, Norrington and Governor Swan are persuaded to let Jack go, despite being a pirate.
Well, I think we can afford to give him one day's head start.
And as for the code...
We figured they were more actual guidelines.
With this reinterpretation of Barbosa's dismissal of the code, Will letting go of his aversion to pirates, Norrington relaxing his a bit, and this overly specific line from Governor Swan.
Perhaps on the rare occasion pursuing the right course demands an act of piracy. Piracy itself can be the right course.
The movie presents its final answer on the thematic question. Rules are fine to have, but to do the right thing, sometimes you gotta be a pirate. Hey guys, hope you got something out of that. As always, you can check out our podcast where we talk more about the entire Pirates trilogy and a whole bunch of other movies. We have merchandise like this t-shirt, stickers, coffee mugs, and this fly-looking notebook available on Zazzle. We also have a Patreon with some bonus content for just $1 a month. Let us know what other movies or topics or anything else that you want us to make videos about in the comments. And if you like what we're doing, go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell so that you can catch all of our new videos. Thanks for watching.